ordered to Chile on earthquake, the biggest Army bomber. It's commanded by Major C.V. Haynes. And now take aboard that cargo. 3,200 pounds of Red Cross medical supplies. That's what's needed in the devastation of southern Chile, where tens of thousands are homeless and epidemic threatens. So load up a lot for a long flight south. Take off from Langley Field, Virginia, and on to the Canal Zone, Lima, Peru, Santiago, Chile, the super flying fortress on a medical relief flight of 4,000 miles.
Graduation day at the West Point of the Air. As Congress speeds an emergency defense bill calling for 5,500 Army planes, Uncle Sam steps up production of military pilots to man his growing Sky Armada. Before the eagle eyes of veteran birdmen, 171 fledglings pass in final review, the largest class in the history of Kelly Field. Flying cadets from nearby Randolph Field, cradle of the year's course, are spectators today. Only top-notchers are transferred to Kelly Field for the last 4 months' training. It costs $13,000 a man to transform dodos, as the newcomers are called, into first-class fighting pilots. They have to be perfect to win their wings from Uncle Sam. The cream of the crop. The first class of 1939, to each a commission as second lieutenant in the Army Air Corps and 3 years active duty. It's good news that three out of four American youngsters today want to be flyers, and no wonder.
Congratulations!
Meanwhile, the 17th Attack Squadron flies over the mountainous Southern California region on one of a series of intensive training flights. These Northrops are the latest type of attack ship. Thirty winged beauties in precision formation, a line of battle that should thrill every American.
The fastest military plane after a record-breaking coast-to-coast flight, ready to land at Mitchell Field. But there's disaster ahead. Losing altitude, can't clear the trees, hits a tree, and there plunges into a gully. From the wreck, Lieutenant Kelsey, the pilot, escapes with only a few bruises. Secret Army plane, a 390-mile-an-hour pursuit ship, believed to be faster than any other military aircraft in the world. Completing a remarkable demonstration flight, there was motor failure, apparently. Near the flying field, crash in a golf course sand trap. The biggest bomber returns from its mercy flight to South America. And at Langley Field, Virginia, the Sky Squadrons are lined up to honor the crew that flew medical supplies to earthquake-stricken Chile. First out, commander of the flight, Major Caleb Haynes. And first in the welcoming group is Air Force Commander, Major General Andrew. Troops at attention, and the super flying fortress takes off for Washington. It transported 3,200 pounds of Red Cross supplies for 4,200 miles to Chilean earthquake sufferers, among whom epidemic was threatening. And now Secretary of War Woodring decorates Commander of the Flight Major Haynes with the Distinguished Flying Cross.
Major, it gives me great pleasure to make this award.
Honoring the flight the warplane made on an errand of mercy.
It's sky defense that has Uncle Sam worried. Major General Arnold, Air Corps Chief, tells you why.
I advise our nation to arm for air defense immediately. France and England must now realize that they began too late. Let us not make that same mistake. I urge them that all remember this. A strong air force may go a long way toward keeping America out of war. Also, a strong air force is absolutely essential to keep war out of America.
with Congress acting to increase the Army's present Air Force by some 3,000 planes, the nation's aviation industry is speeding up to capacity. Many American plants, notably the Douglas, are already deluged with demands from abroad. Faced by a Germany capable of producing 400 planes a month, Great Britain and France have already ordered 1,000 American-made bombers and fighters and are reported planning to buy 2,000 more this year. Fateful days as an alarmed world arms for sky supremacy.
Senate and House Military Affairs Committeemen, make a personal check on the nation's air defenses and see thrilling demonstrations of aerial warfare. Later at Fort Story, see anti-aircraft guns and the new one-pounders in action. Fort Monroe, the roar of the big 12-inch coast defense disappearing gun brings the tour of inspection to a dramatic close.
Precision is the word as Army bombers drill to show their discipline flying on Army Day. They're from March Field, California, the 17th Attack Group under command of Lieutenant Colonel Carlisle Walsh. Formation flight of a dozen bombers. And look at that precision. The bobbing of the bombers tells of air currents over the western mountains. But this 350-mile jaunt at a height of 10,000 feet is flown precisely in formation.
A squadron of speedy pursuit planes at Langley Field, Virginia, push their propellers into the wind and take off in a celebration of Army Day. The United States military forces give a preparedness demonstration on the anniversary of America's entry into the World War. Thirty-nine fighters flying in formation, ready to repulse would-be attackers, combing the skies in a straight line. They're among the fastest fighting planes in the world. Headlined in this air preparedness pageant are the mighty flying fortresses. These giant defense weapons have living accommodations aboard, complete from sleeping quarters to kitchenette. And for sustained operations, they're the most effective military planes ever built. Each is equipped with 4 1,000-horsepower engines and cruises at about 250 miles an hour. The Army Air Force writes a streamlined warning in the sky. America is prepared to defend her own shores.
Students of sky navigation at Randolph Field, Texas, 500 in each class at this Army School of Flying. First, have they the talent, the physical qualities? How will the pupil react to aerial acrobatics? The whirling chair tells that. How dizzy does it make him? And then he breathes rarefied air as at great heights. The cadets have passed their physical tests, and now they'll get their flying lessons. Into each military plane climbs an instructor and the pupil he's to teach. The class is lined up for a takeoff into the schoolroom of the sky, so on with the study. It's a mass takeoff. They're training pilots as fast as they can for preparedness. The pupil in front, the instructor behind him. That's the way cadets are taught to wing swiftly along and do the barrel roll. And it's the way thousands of college lads will be schooled in the civilian training program. The acrobatics of Army flying.
the new $7 million Army Air Depot at Sacramento. Dedication day, so look over the warplanes. On the right, Air Force Commander General Arnold. With him, the new Army Chief of Staff, General Marshall, whose appointment broke precedent. This is the most modern air base in the nation, and is a sign of rapid expansion of American defense aviation. The new Sacramento Army Air Depot is dedicated with high ceremony by the Squadrons of the Sky.